Have a close look at the two sentences on your screen. That they are gentlemen is known to us. Encouraging employees to be punctual is a big ask. Both sentences have their subjects, not a word, but a group of words, which could be a phrase, clause, gerund, or infinitive. These group of words are thus called noun equivalents. Noun equivalent, collectively as a group of words, conveys one idea and therefore takes a singular verb. Let's have a look at some sentences where noun equivalents act as a subject. Exercising with friends is the best way to stay fit. That the universe contains billions of galaxies is a fact. To serve without expectations gives immense satisfaction. This garden with colorful tulips is a major tourist attraction. However, if there are two noun equivalents in a sentence which are joined by a word and, the verb will be plural. For example, playing with dogs and reading books are my favorite hobbies. Her mellifluous voice and his guitar skills make a great combination. Where you work and what you earn do not concern me. I hope now you will not get confused with a group of words acting as subject in any given sentence and will choose the verb correctly. So friends, that's it in this tip. I'll be back with you soon with some more useful information from the world of grammar. Till then, keep learning and keep improving. Goodbye.